just so scary.
There it is. Depth over distance was all I asked of you.
And everybody around you is acting like a star. Good morning and welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all well. There's been a really exciting announcement this morning, and Mark Drakeford, who is the First Minister of Wales, has announced that the stay local rule has been lifted. So we no longer need to stay in Swansea, which is so good. We can travel around Wales now. So I think tomorrow we are going to get away somewhere north, somewhere north, probably Pembrokeshire, but it's gonna be a fun weekend and I want to take you along with us. We'll probably stay in the car, but it is raining, so I think we're gonna just play it by ear because I don't think we really want to be camping in the rain. So yeah, fun weekend. And now we're going to do something really exciting. We're going to the Gower to go and visit a surfboard for Zach. Exciting.
Just gonna say hey to it.
Yeah, just gonna say hi and then drive away, but yeah, very exciting. Let's go. You got it!
Sorry about that, it was really nice.
No, I know.
He's got another mini in there that he's converting for his son right
really?
Now.
Really? So nice,
like
Zach.
A forest green mini.
Aww.
Really, really nice.
So nice. Happy?
Yeah. Just do the job.
So we've just put fuel in and it's such a beautiful day and we are heading on a road trip for the first time in so long, and doesn't it feel so good?
Feels pretty good.
So good. So we are heading to Pembrokeshire today because the regulations got lifted and it's such a good feeling. We've got all our blankets and pillows because we're staying overnight. Let's go. They're going on a road trip. Look how much stuff is. So we just stopped on the way to a Tesco's to buy dinner and we're gonna have a barbecue because it requires minimal washing up and it's just nice and summery. So we bought a iceberg halloumi, a pepper, buns, and that's all for our thing, isn't it?
Yeah.
Also, because we are treating ourselves today, I thought it'd be really fun to treat Seb today. So we're gonna take Seb through a car wash in a sec. Oh yeah, the coffees. I also had an embarrassing moment in there. I have never smashed anything in a shop. I went to grab one of these from the top shelf and it just went and just went on this floor. Coffee everywhere. Nightmare. Absolute nightmare.
I don't remember that. Isn't one. No, there isn't one, is there?
We'll drive past one at some point, I'm sure.
It's closed. It's the second one that's closed. So looks like Seb isn't getting a wash quite yet. I don't really understand the correlation between car washes being open and COVID cases rising, but I guess there must be a reason it's shut, but we're going to decide where we're going to go now.
We haven't done much along the peninsula, or we go all the way down to Dale.
Yeah, that looks nice.
I have no idea what it looks like or what the beach is
like. Yeah, let's go there.
All right, let's go here then.
Come on. Just drove past this place that looked really cool. Oh, it is abandoned. Located just off the A40 in Slaybeck, this beautiful abandoned building called for us to check it out. Strangely, googling Rutzen Abbey showed nothing, but after a bit of research I found that in its former days it was dedicated to St John the Baptist. There must be another way in. There must be. This is so exciting. Look at it. And it's beautiful.
Such a shame.
Such a shame. Formerly a conventual church of the commander based there in 1301, it was used as a stopover for pilgrims on their way to St David's. They're all through there. They've all just been forgotten. That's so sad. Both eerie and beautiful, the wild flow of nature overtaking the Norman architecture and crumbled headstones was quite a sight.
Through the barbed wire. You can walk down there through the hole.
Oh, that's so scary.
I'm not going in there.
That's so scary. You can't even see it on camera. It's so scary. Oh my, Zach, there's lots of flies. I hope there's not a dead body down here.
I bet you could hear that.
No, don't. Look at it. Oh, Zach, there's another hole. Oh my gosh. I reckon there must be a way up, don't you think?
Yeah,
I kind of want to see in it. I'm going to go down a little bit. No, I can't. I can't do it.
You can see through that.
Well, you can't see on camera. Oh, a little bit. I've always wanted to do this. Jump with me. So you see if the horn works?
The horn's not gonna work. It's electric.
Oh, yeah. Imagine if we open the back and there's a dead body in there. I don't know why I'm so obsessed with dead bodies in this.
We're looking at a lock.
Let's get out of this.
Out! Look at the moss. I hope all these people have visited. That was a cool adventure. Next time we need to come back, we need to go down.
Yeah.
I bet someone in the comments of my video is going to be like, oh, I wish you'd gone down that alley and showed us doors down there. We're too wimpy for that, I'm sorry. Next time.
You know those grave cleaning TikToks?
Yeah.
That would be really good for back there.
Yeah. Yeah, that would be.
Like an extreme one.
Oh, yeah. Should we go back there and do some grave cleaning? So, it looks like we're about to drive into the ocean. Martin's Haven. Martin.
Yeah.
Both of mine and Zach's dad. It's called Martin. Fun fact. Very quaint. Goma, this is the island. Marine conservation. Martin's Haven. We are just there. That's the island. So cool.
Stars, squirts and slugs.
Stars, squirts and slugs. So I drove down this road. Got to like here. Didn't see any further. And imagine if I had. I might have been alright, but I wouldn't have wanted to get stuck in all the, the stones. How ominous this is. I wonder whose shoe that was and why it's washed up at sea. In the summer, these waters are much more of a turquoise shade than grey and are home to the boats which transport people to Skoma Island. Please don't fall. Luckily, I didn't end up driving down here as it's super rocky, but that may or may not have been a foreshadowing of what may happen later in the video. It says quarantine. Wildlife on isolated islands is extremely vulnerable to severe disruption by abductions of species from other sites. So like you have to make sure your bags are sealed.
Yeah.
That's crazy. I think this is such a cool landscape. We're literally walking up to an island right now. It's pretty big. I don't even know if you can tell, but it's so windy up here. Whoa. Skoma Island, wow. I got almost lost vibes looking at this island. Located less than a mile off the Pembrokeshire coast, this landscape is home to puffins, manx, shearwaters, dolphins and porpoises, seals, and a multitude of brightly coloured sea slugs, to name a few. During the spring, it's covered in my favourite wildflower, the bluebell, and you can even stay on it overnight, which is definitely on my bucket list. He's like a child.
Intense.
That's so intense. That was so windy. We still haven't decided we're going to stay for the night. No us nomads.
Yeah.
So we're going to Freshwater West, which is now we're back in the other direction. But we've decided that we don't really know this area as well, and we don't want to park overnight somewhere that we don't really know that well. Let's go. Zach just went, puffin! And they're just two fake statues of a puffin.
They look quite real for people.
They do. Okay, I think I need to give it a little warning here. My car is a four-wheel drive and I have taken it off-roading before. And I also get very excited about water and driving and sometimes forget my car only sits 5 inches off the ground. However, all being said, after this I did look under my car thoroughly and this is the worst of the damage. It's still not ideal, but I'm so thankful that was all. I'm really messed up. Seb, I love you so much. I'm so sorry for doing that to you.
I mean, you have, like, the car's like a rally car, but it hasn't got much clearance.
No, but I also wasn't in, I don't know how to put it in four-wheel drive.
Well, so let's go.
Dad's gonna cry when he sees that.
Does it feel alright?
Feels fine. Don't know what you're worrying about.
Oh, if we had got stuck in there.
Yeah, to be fair, that would have been awful. I actually don't know who I would have called. That's the issue. I can't just be like, Dad, come
to
me.
No,
I would have had to call a farmer. Not that I know many farmers.
depth over distance every time, my dear. And this tree of ours may grow tall in the woods, but it's the roots that will bind us here to the ground. Depth over distance was all I asked of you. And I may be foolish to fall as I do, still there's strength in the blindness you fear if you're coming to. If you're coming. Oh, hold on, wait until that long sun breaks from the arms of the Lord. Yeah, hold on, though he may be too young to know this right or wrong. Depth over distance was all I asked of you. And everybody around.
Good morning. We actually didn't get cold overnight. There is so much sand on the car from the storm though. But there's absolutely no one around. I think that's a pretty win-win. So we just drove from Freshwater West to, we've come to St. Govan's Chapel, and we just drove through a military zone, and it had a sign saying, if red flags are flying, don't drive through because there's live firing happening, so that's kind of scary. But we've got to this little car park, and there's a few people camped. I don't know if you can see. And there's lambs everywhere, which is so sweet. They're so, so small. Spring has sprung. So we're gonna put on some warm layers, and we're gonna go explore this chapel. And it's so windy outside, so let's go. Whoa.
That's beautiful. Wow.
Ah, this chapel. The only way I can describe this place is pure magic. St. Govan lived in this mystical building nestled in the cliff face in the 6th century, and although the history around him is pretty murky, with some places noting he was a thief and others a knight, it is, however, known that he was on his way to Wales when he was attacked by Irish pirates. He escaped them by hiding in a cave here and thanked God for the cliffside that saved him. He set up a monastic hermitage in the cove, living off the nature surrounding, and remained there for the rest of his life. I think that hearing the waves crash onto the rocks below will make even an agnostic feel pretty spiritual. Also, legend has it that if you count the steps on the way down and back up again, the number is never the same. So I look like a wet dog and you're steaming up really badly because we've just got in my car. We just met a guy who works for the Pembroke National Park. There we go. And he was telling us all about the area and stuff. He mentioned to us that in the local town, Tenby, there's a walrus, an actual walrus, which is an absolutely insane thing to be in the UK. But apparently he was there yesterday. We don't know if he's gonna be there today, but he's come down and he just likes Tenby. So he's apparently there. He might not be, but we think we might head there and just see if he's there, because if he is, then that would be so cool to see. Usually it's blue here, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's so different.
Oh,
is it?
It is.
There it is. There.
Where?
There.
Oh, yeah. It looks really big. You can't see it at all.
on. So that was just so cool. So cool. The camera hardly did it justice, but no, that was epic. Absolutely epic. Hopefully my phone kind of showed him a bit more, but yesterday he was here and he was on the ramp and he was absolutely massive. So yeah, I feel really grateful to have seen him today. It's been a really, really fun 24 hours and I'm so glad the restrictions lifted enough for us to be able to adventure. It's been absolutely amazing. So we've just pulled up at one of our favorite shops, Hiatus. Zachy's just hopped out to get some wax for his new board and I'm just waiting in the car. And I just hit, see that? There we go. I just hit 900 subscribers and I'm just so stoked and I'm so grateful for you all here on this crazy adventure of life. And yeah, thank you so much for that. It means so much. Anyway, Zach's about to come back, so I'm gonna say goodbye. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give a thumbs up, click subscribe for more, and roll on more adventures.
Hello, it's Zach. I was just wondering if you guys are open at the moment.